Powdery mildew is a disease of wheat, and like most diseases, if it's prolific enough, it'll take the green leaf area from the crop and affect its ability to photosynthesise and fill green, and will reduce yields if it's bad enough.
York Peninsula agronomist Sam Trengove says wheat powdery mildew is becoming an increasing problem across the southern region, in part because of resistance to the most commonly used fungicides.
So it tends to be much more predominant on the lower part of the canopy. You don't often find it up on the flag and the flag minus one leaf until it's well developed.
Early detection is key, and that means getting down deep into the crop base.
Down the bottom here, basically there's mildew pustules, most predominantly on the lower stem, or what we'd call the leaf sheath, so the bit of leaf that wraps around the stem. And there's pustules sort of dotted down the stem there, but then it's also on the lower leaves as well.
Sam's been involved in two projects to research best management practices, one with Saget in 2020, the other a GRDC investment. They involved field trials and analysing grower samples to detect resistance to fungicides. Of the three classes of fungicides registered for wheat in Australia, Group 7 SDHI have very limited control of wheat powdery mildew, and the Group 3 DMI fungicides and Group 11 QOI are also losing efficacy.
The two groups we've been most reliant on are starting to give us unreliable results in terms of control. So it's not as simple as growing the highest yielding variety that's S to VS and saying I'll spray it and control it that way, because sometimes the fungicides aren't working.
The key message here is to choose your wheat variety wisely.
If you're in a region where powdery mildew has historically been an issue, then growing varieties that are rated as susceptible to very susceptible or S to VS will cause issues, because they are so susceptible to the disease that it just proliferates and it's very difficult to control. Moving away from these highly susceptible varieties, the S to VS varieties, into, doesn't have to be a shift all the way up to resistant, but just shifting a couple of categories up to an MSS variety will make a significant impact.
In a follow-up GRDC investment, Nick Poole from Far Australia is investigating wheat powdery mildew in the northern region.
Working with Sam Trengove in the first project phase has helped establish the fact that there are bigger issues with fungicide resistance in the eastern states compared to South Australia. And this could be particularly important to growers in Victoria and New South Wales regions if they're faced with higher levels of wheat powdery mildew.
AFREN has a 5-point set of guidelines to reduce disease pressure and fungicide resistance. Avoid susceptible varieties. Rotate crops to reduce disease carryover, although be aware the spores can stick around on stubble for a number of years. Use non-chemical control methods. Spray only if absolutely necessary, and rotate fungicide mode of action groups.
It's easy for us to say rotate the foliar fungicide modes of action, but actually that's easier said than done, particularly when you bear in mind that those three modes of action are themselves powdery mildew would not be considered their real strengths in terms of control.
There is some hope now, though, in the form of three new APVMA emergency use permits for mildew fighting fungicides.
So these are products that are specific to mildew. So generally we're dealing with a disease complex where you could have septoria and stripe rust, and mildew could also be part of that. So potentially likely to still need a mixture of fungicides if you have these other diseases present that control those, but these will help cover off on the mildew side of the equation.
That would be an additional cost that needs to be factored in. Interestingly, both GRDC projects are revealing whole regions that have used very little fungicide are still showing resistance.
What we read into that is that it's not through their local use or selection of that resistance, but it's actually moved from another region and they've got that resistance via airborne dispersal.
Both researchers agree this is not just an individual grower's issue. It's a communal one.
I think that there's a growing realisation that we're all in this together.